Welcome back to next one. In this session, we are going to develop API verification utility. So in my API verification package, I am going to create a one class, which is API verification. API verification. In this class, we have to write a logic for how we are going to validate the data for multiple get API, post API, delete API, whatever APIs we are going to use. So now first thing is we are going to write a method for validating the status code. So we need to write public static void and response code validation. Response code validation. So first question comes in my mind, why this method is static? Because in each test, I am going to call this method. So I am using that class in my entire framework. So what I have to do, if I am not going to use method as a static, then I have to create an object multiple time. So better, I'll go with the static method. So that's why I'm going with the static method. So in try catch block, what we are going to write, how we are going to validate. Okay, so first thing we need to write is and to validate the status code, we should have a response. So we need to pass response here. Response, and we should have status code as well. So we need to first import the response, which is again JSON. io.restasio.json, and we should have actual status code, which will be int value. So int status code. So in this method, what we are going to do? So whatever response we are getting from the API, we are going to validate with our expected status code. So we are going to assert the data, assert, which comes inside the test ng, assert dot assert equals, it is going to return me a boolean value. So first I have to mention as a expected status code, which is my status code. So I have to pass this status code, and from response I am going to get a status code. So response dot get status code. So this line is going to validate the data. And after that, what we are going to do, we will write in the logger. So test.log. So again, we need to use here extend report, but we have to first extend the extend report class. Extend report listener class. So which is available in the utils package. So we need to write test.log and log status dot pass. If we are able to validate the status code successfully, then we have to log as a pass. So it will make our test pass successfully validated status code, and status code is, so I have to write here status code, so plus this same line. So it will going to print whatever code I am going to get. So this is how we are going to validate. Now we have to put catch block here as well, because let's say my assertion will fail, then my execution is going to stop. That I don't want it. So I have to use catch block here. So catch, and first what I am going to assert. So first will be my assertion error. Assertion error E, and in this I am going to use one more logger. So test.log. Log status dot fail. If I am not able to validate, or if I am expecting status code as a 200, but my API is returning me something else, 304 or 400 or 5xx. So in this case, my test will be fail. So log status dot fail, and I have to write expected status code was status code is, this is I am expecting. So expected status code is this, but instead of getting, we are getting this code. So we have to put valid logger. Yeah, so we can see here, first I am going to assert the status code based on response status code as well as whatever I am going to expect. Now I have to put another catch block, which is exception E. So if error is something else which not belongs to this category, so I am going to use no final category, which is exception E. And again I am going to put test dot log status dot fail, and I am going to print whatever error I am getting. So E dot find my stack trace. So this is I am going to add. Even similar way I can use this statement here as well. So I have a fair idea why my test is failing. I no need to go to the console. From extend report only I will get the fair idea why my test is failed. Now we have to build a utility for the response key validation. Similar way, whatever we have validated here, same method we are going to implement. Public static void response key validation. In this also we need two parameters, which is these two, response and another will be my key. So whatever key I want to validate, so let's say I want to validate as a, in our case we have validated value. So whatever is we got in from this response, we have validated value or title, so we need to pass that value here. So string key, we have to pass a key, whatever key we are going to validate, and again we are going to write in a try catch block. So try catch block, and here we are getting data as a JSON object. So whatever things we have written here, the same thing we have to write there as well, so we can get read out of this code. The same thing I have to write here. So if you are not sure how we have implemented this, please refer previous video, so you will get to know how this works. And get title, so here in that method we have used get title method, because for this particular API we are going to validate title only, but in our case this is utility, so this cannot be hard coded. So what we have to do, we have to pass a parameter as a key instead of title. So let me remove this title, we have to put just simply as a key. So it will going, this method will get the response and it will convert into a string, and then it loop through the entire JSON array. We are going to convert JSON array to JSON object, and we are going to get particular value, and then we are validating the value. We are going to log as a validated values are this. So this will be my first logger, and instead of info this will be a pass, because we have validated here. And in catch block we are going to again put the same statement here. So this will be my statement in the catch block. What if, let's say I am not able to validate my key, or let's say that key is not present. So I'll put some error in a extent report. So this is again one more method. Now another method is we are going to validate the response time. So for that again we can write public static void response time validation. Guys, this is the actual way how we are going to use in an industry or real time project. For response time validation we need only one parameter, which is response. So this method only consume the one parameter, this is response. So again I am going to use try inside my try catch block. I have to write the logic. So from response time, what I am going to do, response dot, I'll get a time. So response dot time. So what I have to do, I have to create a, I have to store as a local variable. So simply what can I do, this is my time and the value will be a long. So this is long because this method is going to return a long value, so I have to store in a long data type. And after then test dot log status dot info, and we are going to write a method. So what we are going to do, API response time is, and simply we have to pass this time value here. So this is how easy way we are develop the utilities. So we have implemented these three methods: response code validation, response key validation, and response time verification. Now what we are going to do, we are going to validate this utility is perfectly working fine or not. So let me go to this test class and let me read out this redundant code. So what I am going to do, I am removing this code. See, when this logger statement is also not at all required because we have used logger statement in utility itself. So what I am going to do, simply API verification dot response code validation. So in response code validation, I have to pass the response and status code. I am expecting my status code 200, so I have to pass it 200. Then again API verification dot response time validation. So I have to pass a response, so it will validate my response time and it will print in the logger. So if I am going to click here, so this method itself log data into the extent report, so no need to use logger as well. So we can read out from multiple lines. API verification dot, I have to validate my key, so this is my response and key. I want to validate title, so as a string value I have to pass a title because this method consumes string value. So string value I have to pass in double quote. If it is int value, then we can directly pass. And after that, I am going to write my test is ended. So my test is ended. So let me run this, run configuration. We have to go to argument when we have to pass valid argument, and let me run this. So execution is completed. Now we are going to check in extend report. So let me again refresh the project. In test folder, we will get the report. So let me go to properties, open it. Yeah, let me open with the browser. So we can see here, this is my test report and whatever value we have written. So successfully validated status code 200. So whatever things we have written here in API verification, successfully validate the status code. So it has validated the status code, and then API response time is 530. So this, it has logged API response time and time is 530. It is milliseconds, and validated values are JSON server and Fundo tester. So title value we have validated. So we have validated title values, and for each key we are getting one key we are getting JSON server and another key we are getting Fundo testers. And after later on we have printed my test is ended. Now let's say my API is returning me something else and I want to validate as a 400. So let me run this test again, run. So my test is running and this time it will fail. Yeah, it is failing. SSN error, expected 200 but found 400. Let me go to the extent report. Yeah, so this is failed. It is showing this line is failed, so it is showing expected 200, and whatever stack trace we are going to fill here, the same thing it will write into a extent report. So because we have used with the logger, so it has printed everything and rest of the utilities is going to execute because we have used catch method here, so it is not going to stop. Otherwise if my assertion will fail, then my execution will stop. After validating my status code, first line is failing, so even though it has executed these two lines as well. So we can see here API response values, so like it will work. So this is how it will work. So now you can see the difference. Here we are going to use 7 to 8 lines, but the same thing we can do within 3 lines. Thank you guys, thanks for watching the video.